Good morning, MSc Fisheries. Today's topic is electroreception in fishes. Electroreception is very well known in the vertebrate. In recent research, it has been shown that bees can detect their presence in the pattern of the static charge of the flower, and they can find the various flower due to their static charges. In vertebrate, the electroreception in the ancestral trait, and it is present in the some common ancestor of the all vertebrates. From the ancestral electroreception, it is known as the ampullary electroreception, while the receiving organ is known as the ampulla of Lorenzani. You all know about the ampulla of Lorenzani, and we have already read in the Scholedon. And this is the ampulla of Lorenzani. This is the exterior opening. This one is the exterior opening. And by the TS, you can see it is the rosette pattern. And it has the nerve ending. This is the nerve ending which is connected to the brain. And so many ampulla of Lorenzani are open exterior through the skin, and their connection through the nerve with the brain. In ampulla Scholedon, you can see the Scholedon where the so many pores are present around the eyes and the mouth opening, and these pores are known as the ampulla of Lorenzani. And this is the structure where the jelly filled canal, and this is the ampulla, and connected all the nerves connected to the brain. Here you can see in the color, and there is a denticles, and in between the denticles there is the opening that is known as the ampulla of Lorenzani. Here is the electric eel. It is consist of the electric organ, that is the hunters, man, and the sex. All these constitute the electric organ, and these are due to the jelly filled structure, and all these are the very highly sensitive. A little bit change in the electrostatic field or the surrounding field, they can detect the prey and the predators. Not all the vertebrates possess the electroreception or ampulla of Lorenzani. In the cartilaginous fishes, especially in the shark, rays, and the chimeras, lungfish, bycaris, coelacanth, sturgeon, paddle fish, aquatic salamander, and the Sicilians. Other vertebrate has the electroreception are the catfish, gymnophones, mordimophones, monotremes, and at least one species of the cetaceans, and they have secondary derived the electroreception. Ampullary electroreception is the passive and predominantly in the predations. In the shark, that is the ampulla of Lorenzani, that receive the electrostatic charge or the electroreception in the passive mode. So it is used by the Scholedon in the predation. Two groups of the teleost fish, have the active electroreception. They are known as the neotropical knife fish, and the family is the gymnotiforms. In the African elephant fishes, that is the notopterid. A rare terrestrial exception in the west long beak echidna, that has a 2000 electroreception on the bill as compared to the 40,000 in the monotremes, that is the semi aquatic and the duckbill platypus. That is the long-beak echidna excessively lives on the terrestrial habitat, so they have the very low number of the electroreception, but it has the feeble eyes, so it detects the prey and the predator with the help of the electroreception. But animal found in the aquatic habitat or the semi-aquatic habitat, it has the large number of the electroreception. You can see the semi-aquatic condition, that is the 40,000 in the ductal platypus. Electroreceptions are used for locate the object around them. It is important in the ecological niche where the animal cannot depend on the vision. Some animals live on the dark side and where the total darkness and no sunlight penetrating up to the that depth, so they totally depend on the electroreceptions. And some animals dwell in the caves and the murky water, and so they detect and defend themselves and catch the prey with the help of the electroreception. In many electric fishes, electric field is used to detect buried prey. If prey is buried under the sand or whatever other vegetations and other hideout place, but due to the very strong electric field and the electroreception organs, they can detect a very small animal with the electroreception. In the shark embryo and the pups freeze when they detect the characteristic electric signal of their predators. So this is the method by they can self defense themselves due to freeze of the electroreception, and it is a very peculiar type of the electroreception found into the shark. In the shark, there are the acute electric sense to detect the earth magnetic field by the detecting weak electric current induced by the swimming or the flow of the ocean currents. The walking behavior of the cockroach can be affected the presence of the static electric field. That's why they avoid the electric field. And now various gadgets are available in the market, so they produce the small electric field around the that gadget. So if there are the cockroach, they will avoid the electric field, so they will not enter into the house or particular place. Cabbage loopers are also known to avoid the electric field. Electrolocation, they are two types: active electrolocation and the passive electrolocation. So there are two types of the electric field. One is the pulse type and another is the wave type. The fish create potential which is smaller than the 1 volt. And the weakly electric field, due to the weak electric field, they can discriminate with the with resistance and the capacitance value may identify in the object. Active electroreception typically is the range about the 1 body length which objects an electrical impedance similar to that of the surrounding water, nearly untouchable. Passive electroreception. In the passive electroreception, the animal has the weak bioelectrical field generated by the other animal to locate them. Due to the weak bioelectrical field, they can detect the animal of the same species. It will emit the current, and it will emit the current. Both have the same wavelength, and both can identify this and this are the same species. A second source of the electrical field in fish in the ion pumps associated with the osmoregulation in the gill membrane. The field is modulated by the opening and the closing of the mouth and the gill slits. By the opening of gill slits and the mouth, they can change their electrical field. And this type of mouth and gill produces electrical field are can identified with the same species. Here are the two animal of the same species. Both will emit the electroreception and can be pursued by the another organism. In the fish, prey of the electromagnetic discharge their prey to detect them. In the many fish, the electrogenic fish produce the electric field to identify the another animal, and it is the very complex process, and the high frequency signal are harder to detect. In the passive electroreception is carried out solely by the ampullary electroreceptor in the fish. in sensitivity, low electric signal below 1, only very small frequency, up to the tens of the hertz. Very large frequency, very large frequency can be created. So it can produce a very low frequency electro reception as well as very high level of the electro reception. In the low electro reception, they used to identify the same species, member of the same species, or a male with the female for the partnership, and high for the detecting or the kill the prey or the predators. Fish in the passive electroreception to supplement or replace their other sensors by the detecting prey and the predators. In shark, sensing an electric dipole alone is sufficient to cause and try to eat it. It is a very good defense organ in the shark. Whenever any predator to kill him, they use the high level of the frequency of electro reception. Electro communication, weak electric field also communicated by the modulating electric waveform generate ability to electro communication. They use to mate attraction and the territorial display for the same species. In some species like the catfishes, they are the agnostic display. In some species, Brachyhippomus, in the South American river fish belonging to family Hypomyidae, commonly known as the blunt nose knife fish. They produce electric discharge pattern in the low voltage and the electrolocative discharge of the electrical eel. It is the hypothesized is the form of the batycine mimicry of the power fully protected the electrical eel. Electroreception in the animal can be from the 20 to 20,000 stimuli. That is a very feeble to very high frequency. The receptor for the electroreception is have the loose plug of the epithelial cell, and they have the sensory receptor for the external environment, and the passive electroreception relies upon the ampullary receptor, which are the sensitivity to a low frequency below the 50 hertz. In the passive electroreception, the frequency should be below the 50 hertz, and the active reception, it should be more than the 50 or 100 hertz. The receptor have the jelly filled canal leading to the sensory receptor of the skin. I have already discussed and explained. The marmid electric fish of the Africa has a tuberous receptor that is known as the nolar organs, and the same electric communication signal. Electroreception is found into very good and the very high precise electroreception in the shark and rays, some bony fishes, monotreme, dolphin and the bees. This example we have already discussed. Thank you.